Good evening. Daniel Andrews has laughed off fresh newspaper speculation about the fall that broke his back at a Sorrento holiday house. The Premier's refused to discuss conspiracy theories as both Labor and the Coalition promised more election cost of living relief. State political reporter Mark Santomartino.
Before this front page had been printed, Martin Pakula summed it up. 3 weeks out from an election, we're being treated to a reheat of bullshit conspiracy theories about where Daniel Andrews broke his back.
Can any of you tell me what the point of this story is? Well, I genuinely don't know. I genuinely don't know what the point of this story is.
What it did reveal was a first look at the stairs the Premier slipped on at the front of a Sorrento home rented in March last year.
What, are you going to interview the stairs next? Like, people can go as low as they want. I'm not coming there with them.
Instead, the Premier was visiting an RSL in Noble Park, vowing to establish a Victorian veterans card that'll shave $100 off the cost of registering a vehicle, offer free boating and fishing licences to cardholders, free trailer and caravan registration, and free public transport on Anzac and Remembrance Day.
To help them with the cost of living, but also just send that very clear message that we value their service, we value their sacrifice.
The card will be completely digital and locked behind the Service Victoria app. It'll cost the budget $37 million to set up, which is merely a fraction of what's being promised today by the opposition.
People wanting to get into their first home won't pay any stamp duty for 12 months, from the 1st of January 2023 for 1 year.
Those homes must be worth less than $1 million, saving buyers like Ben and Cass up to $55,000.
It's what we dream of, and unfortunately how it is right now, to us it seems very unachievable.
It's affordable, it won't break the bank, but it will help a lot of people get into their first home.
Matthew Guy's one-year plan would cost Victoria's budget $260 million. Mark Santomartino, Nine News.